It's not just one person that makes this program. It's our medical and surgical physicians. It's our pharmacists, nutritionists. It's the nurses being on the cardiothoracic unit or in the transplant clinic. There's a lot of people that make up the team, and everybody has such a very important part of that team to take care of these patients.
It's so important to have everyone at the table. For example, in our what we call listing meeting, where we discuss people who are being evaluated for transplantation. You know, our transplant pulmonologists are there, myself and Dr. De Oliveira, the transplant surgeons there, but in addition, our mid-level providers are there.
The more people present, the more people involved with the care of the patient, the higher the chance that things are not going to be missed, higher the chance that you're going to be able to pick up things early, and higher the chance that you're going to have success.
We don't have a high turnover. Our nurses and our physicians, everybody has been here for such a long period of time because we do really feel strongly that this is the place that we want to be. It's our passion.
Often we're encountering people that are very, very ill and in desperate need of a transplant. Their disease process is progressing and they may be in a crisis type of situation at the time of the transplant. So to be able to have that experienced team to handle that very challenging situation is, I think, an important factor.
We are used to dealing with very complex situations. The difficult patient population, as I certainly would say, lung transplant patients are, become the routine.
We work really hard to streamline the referral process and get patients evaluated in a timely fashion.
The first lung transplant done at UW was in 1988. So it has been 25 years and more than 600 transplants. For the past 10 years, we have done about 400 of them. The results speak by themselves and they continue to improve. The 1-year survival is about 88%, the 3-year survival is about 75%. These numbers are better than expected and are better than the national data.
We've now transplanted nearly 100 cystic fibrosis patients within this program. And as we look at the 1-year survival on these patients, it's 94%, which is well above the national average.
Lung transplantation is the highest risk transplantation. We are expecting some bumps on the road. The good thing is most of these bumps on the road we can fix because we have a lot of experience, because we have a lot of people working together, because we are always watching, we are always paying attention to detail.
We have intense relationships with our patients because lung transplantation is a very intense therapy, often fraught with complications. We develop intense relationships with our patients and their families.
And we want to do everything possible for them to have a good outcome and to get back and to have the life that they want to have.
And when you put a new set of lungs in that person and you see them 3, 4, 5, 6 days after surgery saying, "Dr. D, I can breathe now. I already noticed a difference." They're going to be going back to do things that for a long time they had forgotten. And they're simple things, things that we take for granted.
We make a lifelong commitment to them. And with that comes a strong attachment for sure.